Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see the second part of a separately excited DC motor, that is the constant horsepower region, or you can say filled current control. How you can vary filled current to control the speed of the motor, that we are going to see in this video. Now this diagram, if you compare with the previous diagram, that is a closed loop armature voltage control, it is exactly same. Instead of the only the difference is here the armature voltage is kept constant and the filled current will be varied. So here we are going to vary the filled current IF. In previously we kept filled current constant by giving the constant DC volt to the filled terminals, but here we are providing the constant DC voltage to the armature winding, so that armature voltage will be constant and you can change the filled current. Now we, if you remember the characteristics, if you go on decreasing filled current, your speed will increase. That means they are inversely proportional with each other. If the current is decreasing, then only your speed will increase with the decrease in a torque. I'll write the formula. Basically, I measure the power, that is equal to speed into torque. Correct? And in this, if you are varying a filled current, then if decrease in a filled current is there, your torque will decrease and speed will increase. So basically in this region what is happening, your speed is increasing and torque is decreasing. Because there is a increase in a one parameter and decrease in a one parameter, it will keep your power constant, since the region is called as a constant horsepower region. Now let's see here what will happen. Again you have a potentiometer where you have given a plus volt, and this voltage will be from 0 to 10 volt, correct? This will be given to the ramp unit. So ramp unit will give you soft start, and soft start is nothing but it will give you the gradual acceleration of the motor, correct? That means speed is gradually increasing, and that speed is given to the comparator to compare with the actual speed. So here what you are getting at this point is nothing but your reference speed, correct? That is given to the comparator. And from the TACO generator, which is connected over here to the armature winding, will give you the speed of the actual motor, and that will be fed back. If the speed is a different, that is actual speed and the reference speed is different, it will produce an error. That error can be given to the speed controller. Then speed controller will produce an control voltage, that is given to the alpha control unit, that will change the firing angle of the thyristor, and then thyristor operation may change to vary the current. If thyristor operation change with the help of change in a firing angle, the current will also either increase or decrease, and depending on that, if current increases your speed will decrease, but if your current decreases your speed will increase. So if the speed is maximum than the required, speed is more than the required, then you need to increase the filled current. You have to remember this vice versa operation. If your speed is a maximum than the required, then you need to increase filled current, because if you increase filled current, your speed will decrease because you want to decrease the speed. But if you are working on a speed which is a less than the required amount of a speed, then you have to decrease the filled current. If you are decreasing the filled current, your speed will automatically increase and you can reach till the required level. This is how your closed loop filled current control work. So if you, this particular phenomenon or this particular device can be only used where you want to increase the speed more than the base speed. We have seen in characteristics, if you want to increase the speed beyond N base, if you remember the characteristics, then you have to change the filled current. You cannot increase the armature voltage. You have to stop increasing armature voltage at N base. If you want to go beyond that, you can go in the variation of a filled current. So this particular diagram is given for the second session, that is a constant horsepower session region, or you can say it is a a filled current control region. So this is the closed loop filled current control, how it is working. I hope you understood what is closed loop control for the armature voltage and for the filled current. Both are different, but they work in a similar way. So I hope you understand both. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Do subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.